Howdy folks, and welcome to Let's Play Shadowrun Dragonfall. In today's episode, we are hopefully going to continue on our mission to obtain a rather large sum of funds, all after the loading screen. Alright, and we are back. Okay, where we had last left off, we had just finished off our brief tour through the sewers and dealt with some ghouls. That being done, however, I'm going to kind of poke around and see if we can find some more work. Honestly, I am not entirely sure where to go, so we are actually going to return back to the import shop here. See if anything has, or see if anyone has anything good to say. Hopefully they will. Hey Dante, how are you doing? You look down to see a pair of bright eyes set into a scruffy face looking back at you. Dante, Monica's old dog. Looking down into those huge brown eyes, you see intelligence and sadness. On some instinctive level, he must know that his master is gone. Dante lets out a small whine, then rubs his head against your leg. I will pet him. Woof. Indeed, Dante. Indeed. Oh, he's following me now. Let's see. Paul, do you have any news for us? Not really, no. Okay. Let's go bug Dietrich here. Hey, boss! Dietrich gives you a slight nod. What can I do for you? Any thoughts on that last run you'd like to share? Not right now, boss. I've got a lot on my mind. Alright, take it easy. He nods. Take it easy. Everybody says take it easy in the grim dark future of Shadowrun. Alright, let's see if we've got anything new on our rig here. Zero unread messages. Open the jobs directory. View all pending and active jobs. Pending, here we go. So we've got a pharma cleanup job and a MKVI prototype extraction. Mark 6. Amsel's face winks onto the screen. Devon, here you will find the complete transcript of my conversation with Herr Schmidt, a potential client. As you will see, the details of the job are a bit more vague than I would like, but the payout is quite substantial. After reading the transcript, you may choose whether or not to accept the job. If you respond in the affirmative, our client will be notified and I will make all necessary preparations for the run. One other thing. Herr Schmidt provided me with a device to assist you on the run. He calls it a little black box. Apparently, it can be used to compromise the power and security systems of the run site. If you opt to take the job, be sure to take it with you. Amsel's image flickers, then winks away. A moment later, a glowing blue text field begins to scroll up from the bottom of the screen. Alright. Guest. Greetings, Herr Amsel. I trust that this connection is secure. P. Amsel. Naturally. To whom do I have the pleasure of speaking? Guest. Call me Herr Schmidt. Alright. P. Amsel. Very well, Herr Schmidt. You have some business for me? Guest. Indeed. I have a job for your team. A simple matter, judging by what I have heard of your team. I imagine that they will be well suited to the task. Go on. Guest. The interests that I represent have learned that AG Chemi Europa is working on a company-wide project. Something very secret, very new. Reliable sources inform me that they're keeping a working prototype of this new venture at their Berlin facility. P. Amsel. I see. And your employers wish us to acquire this prototype for them. Guest. Naturally. P. Amsel. What is this project? If you want my team to grab the prototype for you, they'll need to know what they're looking for. Guest. I'm not at liberty to say. I can tell you that the prototype has been branded MKVI. I can also tell you that your team will find it on the 25th floor of the Berlin facility, in the office of one, oh god, Albrecht Haushofer? Further, I can assist your team in disabling the building's security and gaining access to the 24th floor. From there, however, they will be on their own. P. Amsel. Such vagueness can be dangerous, Herr Schmidt. I will not commit my team to a run without better understanding of what the job entails. Guest. Facing such dangers is the purpose of a shadow runner, Herr Amsel. Your team will be rewarded handsomely for their services. My employers have set aside 20,000 New Yen for the job. Holy crap. Consider it hazard pay if you wish. P. Amsel. Make it 25,000 New Yen or look somewhere else. Guest. 22,500 New Yen. Final offer. P. Amsel. Very well. I will pass your offer on to my team. Are there any further details that you can provide? Guest. Hoshifer's office will be locked behind a vault door. The lock is old-fashioned of the mechanical variety. I will provide your team with a copy of the key. I will also supply you with a little black box, a solid-state device that your team can use to override a variety of building systems. Your team will enter through the facility's underground garage. When your team has acquired the MKVI, have them exit through the same garage. I will have a van there waiting to extract them. P. Amsel. Thank you, Herr Schmidt. I will pass your offer on to my team. Guest. Good day, Herr Amsel. The text field disappears. A single line of text pops into the center of the screen, taking its place. Accept job. Yes, no. Abort, retry, fail. We are going to accept it. Run accepted. Client notification sent. You take the little black box from the desk and pocket it before returning your attention to the screen. Okay. I'm going to leave the pharma cleanup job here pending, because we're going to go and get this one done. I am sure that this is probably a trap of some horrible, horrible variety. However, we are well equipped to deal with traps, notably in that we have guns, and we're pretty good with them. So let's go get this show on the road. Come, Dante. Yes, my loyal dog minion. Okay. Assemble a team and travel to the AG Chemi Europa facility to extract the MKVI prototype. I'm just going to start calling the Mark 6 prototype, because I'm sure that's probably what they were going for. Alright, as per usual, we are using Glory, Blitz, and Dietrich. Who? I think they're all about where they were previously. I think his Nerve Bolt might have leveled up. I don't know. Regardless. Yes. Confirm! Alright, flavor text from the loading screen. Come on. Monolithic, plastic, sterile. The Berlin office of AG Chemi Europa is all of these things and more. The worst qualities of modern corporate culture, all mixed into a toxic stew and sluiced with a single prefab office building. Thankfully, you shouldn't have to stay long. According to the intel that your client provided, this should be a simple smash-and-grab operation, and you've been given the tools to carry it out with a minimum of fuss. The Mark 6 prototype, whatever it is waiting for you on the 25th floor. It's time to go and get it. Alright. And I think everybody is pretty well good. I'm happy with what I've got there. So, in we go. This has got to be a trap. I would be surprised if this wasn't a trap of some sort. Alright, do we have anything floating around? No. Alright, so we've got a way there, and we got a way there. Let us poke around. Come on. Grace have been sealed. The only visible markings are Project Atlas. Alright. Ooh, an advanced med kit. We'll send it to our stash. There's something over there. Can we open this? Yes, we can. Okay, come on. Come on, there we go. After a few moments of sifting through cables, you find a diagnostic connector with the right input to fit the little black box that Herr Schmidt gave you. Sure. The connector slips into the box with a satisfying click. A tiny red light set into the box's lid begins flashing. After a few seconds, it turns yellow, and then finally shifts to green. At that instant, all of the lights in the garage turn off. A few seconds later, the emergency lighting kicks in. If what Schmidt told you was true, you just killed the main power for most of the building. In theory, the box has also circumvented the security cameras on the building's upper floors. You should be able to intercept the camera feeds by tapping into an elevator console on the 24th floor. Handy little thing. Alright. Without warning, your comlink screen bursts into static. You hear a telltale series of clicks. Someone has established an audio connection to your comlink. A moment later, a deep, sonorous voice speaks into your ear. You recognize it instantly. Your lodge contact, Luca Duer. Devon, do not speak, just listen. I have a proposition for you. I understand that your team is currently en route to retrieve a package, the Mark 6 prototype, if I'm not mistaken. My associates and I are interested in acquiring the Mark 6 for our own studies. We'd like you to deliver a device to us. Once you've acquired the Mark VI, you will proceed back to the garage as planned. There you will find a transport packed inside your client's van. Load the Mark VI into the transport, and you will be rewarded. Herr Schmidt will also be dealt with to protect you from reprisal. To accept our offer, simply proceed as instructed and return the prototype to us. Please note that we need the Mark VI in undamaged condition. If it's not in full working order, it's useless to us. As I'm sure you are aware, the Lodge takes good care of its friends. Trust me, Devon. It would be to your advantage to help us. The line goes dead with a click. A moment later, the sons of your teammates' comm chatter return. They are apparently unaware of the message that you just received. We're gonna tell the team this. I don't know about that. Betraying a client is bad business, and right now we need all the business we can get. Yeah, but disappointing the Lodge isn't a great move either. They have pull, Devon. A lot of pull. We're gonna do this for the dude that contracted us. We're not gonna do some backroom dealing here. That is not Devon's way. He's not going to start doing it now. Glory nods. I know that'll make me sleep easier at night. Yeah, and I'll spend my days looking over my shoulder. Nah, you're fine, Blitz. Quit being a wuss. Okay. Blitz steps up to a console built into the wall inside the elevator. This is it, Chief. All the camera feeds are right here. Shall I? Without waiting for a response, he taps a couple of keys on the console and your PDA starts receiving visuals from around the building. Good work, Blitz. Let's find a way upstairs. Okay. So we do have cameras everywhere. Cool. That's actually kind of handy. Alright, well, we gotta find a way up. There's loot there. Somebody dead in there or something. Alright, well, we're gonna move down here. What do we have here? Laboratory entrance. Toxic gas detected. Oh, nice. Lab lockdown engaged. Ooh, optional objective, clear the gas from the lab. Alright. See about maybe being able to do that. A warning light strobes out from the console at your approach. Large white letters shriek out against a red background. Warning: toxic gas containment. Toxic containment detected. COCI2 phosphine. Phosgene gas. Hazardous material override engaged. Laboratory entrances locked down. Input command. I'm probably gonna end up killing myself. Alright, let's purge the lab of all air. There's only venting of containment. Exterior atmosphere, okay. We do not want to do that, because that'll fucking kill everybody. Alright, what's our substance library? Use direct terminal access. Alright, introduce gaseous agent to laboratory atmosphere. Please input agent to introduce. No idea. Well, we can disengage the lockdown. Can I disengage? Oh, no, we can't. Alright, so we're gonna walk away. I do not even wanna, like, no. I'll end up killing myself. Or everyone, and I don't wanna do that. Devon has no problem killing people, but he is not a wanton murderer. Oh, what do we have here? Data store and records. Really? Come on, guys. Alright, so we've got something there. And doesn't look like anything else. Alright. Welcome to the AGC Data Library Archive and Employee Record System. Enter search terms to begin. Alright. Can I do phosgene gas? Alright, here we go. I think that's COCL2. Temporary known as phosgene gas. Highly toxic, colorless gas, gained infamy for its use as a chemical weapon during the First World War. It's also valued as an industrial reagent, as an organic building block from which pharmaceuticals and other compounds can be synthesized. Low concentration is reminiscent of freshly cut grass. The odor detection threshold for phosgene is 0.4 ppm, 4 times its threshold limit value. Phosgene-related deaths are generally caused by the interaction of the gas and proteins of the pulmonary alveoli. The end result is in destruction of the blood-air barrier, preventing the transmission of oxygen to the blood. Death by suffocation inevitably follows. It's highly recommended that any employee working in or around this gas wear a detector badge. A suitable supply of sodium bicarbonate for liquid phosgene and ammonia for gaseous phosgene must be kept on hand to neutralize spills and leakages. Alright, ammonia. You find yourself deposited back in the main menu. Alright. Let's go try ammonia then. Look at them go. They're booking. Oh, is it going to cut through walls? No. Dang. I'm never going to get over that. My party members running through the walls. Alright. Substance list. Oh, damn it. Okay. Disengage lockdown. No contaminants detected. Disengaging lockdown. Ha ha! Karma get! Plus there might be some goodies in there, who knows. Sorry, doctor. Scientist lays dead beside a small pile of smashed glass, and a number of beakers have been knocked over on a nearby table. Alright, well, we're gonna loot first. Combat stim. No. Not big on the drugs. Oh, hopefully this is another med kit. It is, in fact, another med kit. Sweet. To the stash. That's saving me money. Alright, what do we got here? On the counter is a note, carefully transcribed in neat handwriting. The paper bears the letterhead of senior executive Leonard Stromberg. I'm still waiting for that report. When I said ASAP, I meant I needed it yesterday. Stay until you've completed the test, then leave the report on my desk. The door code is 54139. Do this tonight. I'll expect to see it waiting for me when I arrive tomorrow. Stromberg. But we just got a door key. That's handy. Computer's powered on, but in sleep mode. When the screen comes to life, you find a half-written text file on the screen. The timestamp of the most recent edit tells you that it was written just a few minutes ago. I didn't sleep last night. Doesn't look like I'm gonna sleep tonight either. Last test batch failed. My fault. Got the mixture wrong. Sloppy work, Jensen. Can barely keep my eyes open. Gotta try again, though. No excuses in this office. I despise relying on stimulants, but I've got no choice. Gotta keep going. Progress marches on. Started the new batch. If house chauffeur's pet isn't ready to be tested tomorrow, well, best not think about that. Gotta concentrate. Remember lab safety. Keep alert. Keep awake. One wrong move could spell disaster. And then a lot of T's. Glancing back at the menu, it looks like there are log entries reaching back for 2 weeks. All of the entries are attributed to the same author, and none of them appear to be password protected. Alright, let's go 2 weeks ago. New formula arrived today. Formula 17. I swear whoever names these things must have no imagination at all. Formula 17? Honestly. Still, I can't wait to start working with it. From what I've read, early clinical trials were promising in the extreme. Amazingly potent, this stuff. And increased potency means less frequent injections at lower dosages. There's nothing not to like. Despite my enthusiasm, there's still much to be done. Speeding up absorption rates is first on the list, and I have some concerns regarding the subject's immune reactions. Perhaps the formula could be tailored on a patient-by-patient basis. Alright, entry dated last week. Tailoring doses to individual patients has worked wonders. The key is taking a gene therapy-based approach. They've been using it in medicine for ages, so why not apply the same logic here? So in a nutshell, I've used the subject's own DNA to delude their immune systems into believing that Formula 17 belongs in their bodies. Simple and effective. This approach has helped to increase the formula's absorption rate, as well as significantly reducing incidences of rejection. Unfortunately, it also rules out an easily mass-produced product, but I'm convinced that the results will justify the additional costs. Alright, yesterday's entry. A week. He waits an entire week before telling me that tailoring the mixture is an unacceptable solution. And then he tells me that the trials are to begin tomorrow. I have no time. And Giesbrecht's applying so much pressure that I can barely think. Bastard. Haushofer's probably threatening him. All of them can rot. Maybe now that Haushofer's playing heat the sheets with Giesbrecht's secretary, he'll learn to lighten up. We can only hope. Anyway, I've had some new ideas to move forward with the formula. Admittedly, they're far-fetched, possibly even dangerous. But if I don't start producing some results, I get the feeling that it won't be a problem for much longer. Wish me luck, Journal. It's science time. Okay. Well, he did science and paid the price, apparently. We'll get out of here and go somewhere else. Alright, well, we've got a ladder, or a ladder, an elevator there. See, this might be that. I'm going to assume this is that guy's office because the door is locked. How we can know that just from looking at the cameras, I don't know, but I'll take it. What do we have here? Maintenance. Oh, that sounds fun. And maybe another med kit. I am pleased with all of these med kits. Oh, this is just a basic one, though. That's okay. It's better than nothing. Come on, guys. Open the door. There we go. I didn't check what this was. What is this? Junior Executive Warner Hardiger? I don't know. Okay. On the bar, a number of bottles of alcohol. Most of them look expensive. Oh, we're going to use our etiquette socialite and examine the bottles. Upon closer examination, you can see the bottles on the top of the bar aren't terribly exciting. Good booze, certainly, but nothing to write home about. Tucked away under the bar, however, you find an unopened bottle of Islay Scotch. The handwritten label announces it as the first bottle from a batch distilled nearly 50 years ago, aged in a cask that had once held Amontillado. To the right buyer, this could be worth some serious money. Sweet. Alright, what else we got? At first glance, this terminal appears unremarkable. Its password locked and a cheerful screensaver marches across its display. Well, let's inspect it. Upon closer inspection, you notice something interspersed among the colorful bouncing sprites on the screensaver. There's a symbol you recognize, the dead drop marker of the Shockwellen writer. Really? As you study the display, a green light winks on above the terminal's display, the recording light of a pinhole camera. The screensaver disappears and the screen floods with glowing green text. Shockwell and Ryder contributor number 1432 recognized. Welcome, Devon. Secret projects. This is an open request for information about the projects and material prototypes being developed at this facility. It is known that there's a synthetic drugs being developed here in support of a project called Atlas. In addition, a functional prototype called the Mark 6 has been developed. The first contributor to provide us with the project data for Atlas, the chemical formula for the new drug, and visual records of the Mark 6 in operation will be handsomely rewarded. All three pieces are required for payout. Alright. AG Chemi Europa is known to be a heartless corporation with little regard for metahuman safety or morality. They guard their secrets jealously and seek to hoard all information gained for themselves. This behavior cannot be allowed to go unpunished. What they know, all shall know. No longer will they hide their secrets in the shadows. The timely delivery of this information will be well rewarded. Freedom, equality, information. Shockwell and Wire Writer. Okay. In that case, I'm going to come back down in here and see if there's, like, information on this computer regarding the... that... Formula 17 drug. Yep. No. Can we reread it? Does it do anything for us? No. Okay, is there anything else in here? No. Alright, that's fine. Just figured I'd double check, just to make sure. Let's go bust into this dude's room. And of course I'm gonna break into this room with all the goons in it and kill all of them, but that's going to happen possibly next episode, we'll see. Senior Executive Leonard Stromberg, Secretary and Annika Schroeder. Alright, what is the password here? 54139. Really? Examine the keypad in astral space. Probably like see ghosts of people typing in the code or something. Stack of business card on this desk reveals that it belongs to one Annika Schroeder. Cursory search reveals that the desk drawers are stuffed full of lewd love notes, all hastily written on scraps of Asha's stationery. We'll rummage through them. Exploring Annika's desk is like embarking on an odyssey of filth. 30 seconds in and you've already learned three new euphemisms for sex in a storage closet, as well as exciting new definitions for a variety of common office terms. Thankfully, your search also turns up something of more immediate value, a scrap of paper with a five-digit code scribbled on it. How chauffeur, 84792. Really? Oh, there's something in here I missed. Oh, that's the booze, never mind. On the desk is a file folder labeled Project Atlas. Yoink! It's empty except for a single note. Moved to digital archive and locked under executive authorization. Dang it. What's this gonna do? Oh, this is just the same thing, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, so it's in a digital archive. Well, let's come down here into the archive room. Let's see if we can pull it up on the computer. Alright, Atlas. Oh, crap. I, of course, wasn't paying attention. 84792. Authorization accepted. Welcome, Herr Hauschefer. Mark 6 prototype data stored under Project Atlas heading. Redirecting inquiry. Project Atlas. Volumes of information begin to flit across the screen. A good half of what you're seeing has been redacted, and the rest is written in possibly dense corpse speak. Well, we're going to download it. Alright, then we're going to access the visual record here. VP level authorization required. Do you wish to proceed? Yes. Damn. Oh, and our Decker can't do it. Nah. Back. Alright. So we're gonna have to come back to that. Because he's not the vice president, is he? No. Senior executive. That's okay. Alright, time for some of the good old ultra-violence. Hey guys! that dude just chose ink. Yes, the mage is like, I'm gonna come out and stick my face in front of everybody and get the crap blown out of me. Yup. Could have told you that was gonna happen. What's she got here? Flashbang. It's two. Dietrich, you're bleeding, I think. Debating on whether or not... I'm gonna haste glory. Or I'd have her run in here and pitch a flashbang grenade at these guys. Alright, glory, go there. Introduce them. Well, see, I'm gonna assume he doesn't have a weapon, so I think that's, yeah, a mage. Captain, guard, enforcer. I'm gonna go for these two. Throw it right there. Don't you miss. Ha! Alright, Blitz. You are you, and I guess I'm just gonna have him run in. Oh no! They're shooting at the little robot dude! And fireballing me. Oh, I'm gonna freaking wreck you for that. Sucking mages. Alright, can't hit him, but I can hit this guy. Ah, Devon, you are so lethal. Okay, I wanna just open up on that mage. I wanna get him down as soon as possible. Glory actually did really well there. Alright, take an aimed burst here. Seriously. Thank you. Okay, and... Alright, Dietrich, come over here, and Dragon Slayer Idol. Uh-oh. Oh, frickin' hand grenades! Alright, we are going to squeak on up here, And Deadeye Shot increases accuracy by 20%. We do not need that much accuracy, because we're not going to miss. Yeah. Alright, Glory, you... Activate your adrenal gland, or your adrenal pump, or whatever it is. Do not reload, I want you to go and tear this dude's face off. Seriously, 90% chance to hit, and you miss. Friggin'. Ugh. Okay. Yeah, we're just gonna. Only got her once. There we go. Dietrich. Just have him fireball her. I don't want to get Devon. Alright, that gets fun. That does not, though. And boom. That was easy. Alright, I'm just gonna switch over to Glory here, and hopefully she will... Seriously. No, just pull back. Freaking three chances at 75% chance to hit, and she misses all of them. I got nothing. Hey there, guy. How are you doing? Is your haste ready again, Dietrich, by any chance? Oh, it is. Oh, but you can't get Devon with it. Damn. I should have cast it on him first before he moved. Oh, well. Didn't matter. Killed the dwarf anyways. Alright, we got loots. What kind of loots? Ooh, a Mossberg. Don't I have one of those, even with a smart link? Yes, I do. I believe. Ah, that kind of chaps my butt a little bit. Because, yeah, here. There. If mine wasn't a smart link, it is now. I don't remember. I think mine was a smart link, but I'm not 100% sure. Okay. Well, it looks like we have cleared this level. So I'm going to come down here and open this door. We're going to come over here. Yeah, I would say, we've gotten everything. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and save it here real quick, and this is where we're going to call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time on the next exciting episode of Shadowrun Returns. Until then.